sister Drew been out with me?
No. No, I ran into Drew, and as always, he reminded me of Oscar, and I felt my chest tightening, like it has every day since Oscar died, and I realized I am choking. I am literally choking on missing my son. Could you please just let me say this, okay? I came to poor Charles in the hope that Oscar would be able to connect with his family, his father's family, and he was able to do more than I could ever wish for him. He found his father, and he had an extended family, and he had a sense of where he came from and where he belonged. And he found Jocelyn, and he had love, and Oscar found a home here. And I just cannot bear to be here without him.
Someone you don't recognize?
I feel terrible for Lulu.
So do I.
Dear Lord. Four. Sorry. And you chose McCutcheon Hall at PCU because you wanted to be close to home.
Yeah, because I wanted to be close to you. I'm sorry, do you think I made a mistake or picked the wrong school?
No. But I've watched you, Mom. And the thing that really gets you excited, the thing that you are most passionate about, is your writing. When you were planning that expose on DOD, you were on fire. So it's not that I don't think you would make a great lawyer. You would.
You don't think I would be happy?
Maybe. Probably. Look, something I've seen in med school is that there is a difference between people who have a genuine passion for medicine, vocation, and people who are doing it just because they think they should. Or because it's the safe career, because they've always been good at science. Those are the people that burn out.
Okay, but med school is really hard.
No doubt. The hours I spend in the hospital are brutal. But I get way more out of it than I put in because of the work itself. So while I 100% believe that you would succeed in a legal career, I don't know, baby. You're too gifted. You're too full of life. You're too young for that just to be your only option because everyone expects it.
Yeah, well, if Shiloh is coming for you, he's got to go through me.
I appreciate that, but I think if Shiloh was coming for me, I'd do it by now.
But it is your memory he wants.
Yeah, well, hypothetically, he doesn't need me to access them.
This is an experiment on twins.
Yeah. I may have been with Shiloh in Afghanistan, but it was my brother who ruined his life.
We gotta locate Jason.
I did find a home here. And I fell in love with a remarkable man. And God knows your love was my only lifeline at times.
You were mine as well. I mean, this is why I love it when you call me Charlie. Because Charlie's a much better man than Julian Drum ever was. Hey, you gave that to me.
Don't you underestimate yourself. You are a good man. You deserve so much better than I'm able to give you right now. It'll be better for you if I go.
You know, Kim, you keep saying the word love, but you don't love me enough to stay in town. You don't love me enough to ask me to go with you, so you need to be honest with me. I mean, maybe you're not just trying to put poor Charles behind you. Maybe you're trying to put me behind you as well.
Have you been in the sun too long? We just picked all that up.
Yeah, and some of them were super disgusting. If you don't want to go to the beach, just say so.
Of course I want to go to the beach. You guys don't understand. A community service isn't like doing chores at home. I'm supposed to do a certain amount of hours. If I finish this assignment, they're just going to send me somewhere else.
Like the beach?
Well, last week someone had to clean out the garden shed. There were snakes in there.
Cool.
Okay, so not the point.
No like snakes.
Well, I don't.
Okay. We got this. I know exactly what to do.
Sam's not big enough.
Neither is Jason. Sam and Jason, all the wiped out DOD, they got charges against Shiloh lined up that would put him away in Pentonville for life.
That's right. It's a thing of the payback. If he wipes out Jason's memories or replaces them with mine as a younger man, then Jason, he loses all connection with his life as he knows it now.
Better make up your mind about before time makes it up for you.
Jump right in and try and give me advice or fix things. doing to her.
Yeah, but don't you owe it to yourself to find out? How about this? Maybe the classes you were gonna take this summer to get a leg up in law school, maybe instead you take that time to write. There's no downside.
Well, there kind of is.
How?
What if I love it?
Right? Well, how is that a downside?
Okay, if I stick with the lawyer plan, then I will be done with school in 3 years, and then 2 years as a public defender after that, and then I get hired by a serious law firm. Hopefully.
Definitely.
Serious firm means serious money, and serious money means we can finally start to make a dent in our student loans.
No, Molly. I work with people who are seriously ill or dying. And let me tell you, you do not want to be lying in a hospital 70 years from now, realizing you never actually achieved any of your real ambitions. But hey, you got your bills paid.
You need a little bit of imagination. Like, imagine this whole pile of junk isn't there because, in fact, it won't be for long. I have a whole garbage hauler coming to haul it away. I love old houses like this, but it's way too big for one person. Oh, no. See, that's where your imagination has to come into play, too. Because, actually, if the seller doesn't get the price, he may want to renovate and turn it into condos. Hey, you want to see inside? Okay.
Until it was terrifying.
terrifying.
Yeah. I mean, when I realized that I was falling for you, well, then it got scary. I mean, what if you didn't feel the same way? And even scarier, what if you did? I mean, how could I possibly manage to not ruin everything considering I'd never had a significant relationship?
Yeah, but real relationships, they are terrifying. For all of the reasons you just mentioned. But you know what?
What?
The fact that you feel that way, that those wonderful feelings go hand in hand with terror, that's a good thing.
Yeah?
Yeah. It means your heart's all in it. You're all in.
Well, with you, I have no choice.
Myself as an intern to Peter August.
I will always love and respect you, but do I want you to go over there? Hell yeah. So if Sasha and I ran into somebody who knew you.
On the island?
Yeah. She said she unsuccessfully tried to make a deal with you. Sandy Lance.
I've never heard of her.
She looked familiar to me while I played here, but she stayed at the Metro Court when she was in town. I don't know.
Okay.
She's blonde.
Hold on. Drew.
Sonny. Hi. Is Jason with you?
No, what's up?
Chris and I think that Shiloh put a target on his back, and we haven't been able to locate Jason or Sam.
I'll find him.
Okay, great. We're gonna track down Shiloh.
Thanks for reaching out.
Hey, Sonny, let me know if Jason's okay, all right?
Yeah, I'll have him call you.
What is it?
Have you heard from Jason today?
No. Why, is something wrong?
Drew seems to think so, and, it involves Shiloh.
Come with you.
Yeah, we'll see what's going on here.
Yes, I've had my struggles getting over Julia, but you know better than anyone else that I have no intention of reuniting with him.
The point is, we can't go back to two people who met at a bar. You know, being a therapist is not a switch I can turn on and off when I leave the office.
I know. That's what I like about you. Your humanity is what I trust.
Don't know me. You know a few things about me. You know why I do the work I do, but I'm no more developed a human being than the night we met at Charlie's.
And yet you've been all in my psychological nooks and crannies.
That's a picturesque way of putting it.
Would you like to come back inside? So, how about we find a way to get on equal footing, and you let me have a chance to get to know you better? Unless you think I'm too damaged to risk getting close to.
Such a pretty house. I'm sure the apartments will be lovely.
Oh, definitely. Count on that.
But I need a place now. Even if the owner decides to convert to condos, it's gonna take months.
That is true, but you know, I was just thinking that because you are a friend of the owner, he might be able to speed up the time frame. Excuse me? Michael Corinthos? You know, at least with him, you know you're in very good hands.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to pass. It feels like a conflict of interest.
Really? What? You know what I think? I think you're overthinking this. I mean, Michael, he is absolutely adorable. And you are absolutely adorable. And I remember seeing you now at the nurse's ball, and you two look just so amazing together. So have you had any chance to think about my offer?
I'm not a model.
I know, but you're just such a... you're just this natural beauty, you know? So I've been thinking, I do so love real estate, but, I don't know, maybe the universe is telling me to take a different path. Excuse me? I really believe that you are the face to relaunch deception. You know what? Let me just tell you about deception. It's a fantastic... I mean, it was. It could be because it's a modern company for a modern woman, a strong woman. Doesn't let her intrinsic...
can't. I'm working.
Oh, please. I've seen you devour one of these in like 5 seconds. Okay, you have the time. Here.
Thanks. Wow. You guys did a killer job. It will definitely take me until the end of my shift to clean all this up.
You're welcome.
So it's a little bit not super sunny for the beach. Maybe a movie?
I don't know.
Come on, Joss. I've been working here in the heat all afternoon. I need to do something fun.
Okay. Okay, but only if I get to pick the movie?
Deal.
Okay, text me when you're done.
I will.
Keep up the good work, Cam.
Sir, are you okay? Oh my God, do you need me to